Good morning, students. I hope you all are studying regularly and doing your assignments. Today, we are going to start with a new poem, Geography Lesson, by Zulfikar Ghosh. The poem is about the way Earth looks from different altitudes. It describes the poet's opinion of land below when he viewed from the sky. The poet realizes that there is more water on the earth than land. Valleys are more populated. He also understands that there are many boundaries on earth that lead to hatred among people. Now comes the poem. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing its scale 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style. When the jet sprang into the sky. This is the first stanza of the poem where the poet tells us, he describes the city. He tells us how it appears from the window of a jet. It is clear that the city is developed as per the necessity and did not grow as per the proper planning. It does not have any particular style. It is disorganized. It even looked 6 inches from a certain height, revealing its true structure. When this poet was in the sky, when he saw the city from there, he saw that everything there was haphazard. That means it was disorganized and it couldn't the place was unplanned, and he could observe that it was developed according to the necessity of the people. Next stanza. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys are populated. The logic of geography, the land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated when the poet jet reached 10,000 feet. In the second stanza, the poet tells us when the plane rises to a height of 10,000 feet, the poet can see the logic of geography. He can see why the cities in the country have grown along the rivers, as water fulfilled the necessities like agriculture, transport, business, etc. He found that valleys were more populated because which met the necessities of the people. Land and water attracted man. This was clearly shown there, delineated. Hair means shown. The last stanza. When the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From that height, it was not clear why. In the third stanza, the poet tells us that when the jet went 6 miles, the poet understood that the earth is round and it consists of land masses and endless water. That is, earth has more sea than land. But the poet is unable to understand why people hate each other, why they have built walls. He reflected that people on earth are selfish and narrow, for they hate each other. He found that the earth to be one, but not the people living on this earth, who are divided for shallow reasons. This was the explanation of the poem. Now it's time for the summary of the poem. I'm going to summarize the poem for you. Here in this poem, the poet tells us how the city appears from the window of a jet. It is clear that the city is developed as per the necessity and did not grow as per the proper planning. That is, it was disorganized. It does not have any particular style. It is unplanned. It even looked 6 inches from a certain height, revealing its true structure. When the plane rises to a height of 10,000 feet, the poet can see the logic of geography there. He can see why the cities in the country have grown along the rivers, as water fulfilled these necessities like agriculture, transport, business, etc. He found that the valleys were more populated, which met the necessities of the people. He saw it was clearly shown there that land and water attracted man. Now, in third stanza, when the jet went above the 6 miles, the poet understood that the earth is round and consists of land masses and endless water. That is to say that it had more sea than land. But the poet is unable to understand why the people hate each other, why they have built walls. In the poem, he reflected that the people on the earth are selfish and narrow, for they hate each other. He found that the earth to be one, but not the people living on this earth, who are divided for shallow reasons. There are few things in the poem that were clear, but there were few things that were not clear from the height. Now, it's turn for the question answers, that is working with text. Before coming to working with text, I would like to discuss the misunderstood words with you. First one is sprang. Sprang means rise. Inevitability, it means unavoidable. Haphazard, it means disorganized or unplanned. Again, when I talk about delineated, it means shown. These are the difficult words, or you may say the misunderstood words. Now, we come to the working with text, and after the working with text, we are going to discuss about the rhyming scheme and the figure of speech. The first question is, find out 3 or 4 phrases in the stanza, 1 or 2 which are likely to occur in geography lesson. Find 3 or 4 phrases in stanzas, 1 and 2 which are likely to occur in a geography lesson. Okay, we come to the first answer. If you could see, I'll come back to the poem first. Phrases, you can just see here. The city had developed the way it had. It scaled 6 inches 2 miles. Second, cities where the rivers ran. Third, the valleys were more populated. This is your first answer. Now, seen from the window of an aeroplane, the city appears as half a hazard as on the ground, as neat as a map, as developed as necessary. Mark the right answer. Which is the right answer here? If I say seen from the window of an aeroplane, the city appears as haphazard as on the ground. Okay, now come to the third question. Which of the following statements are examples of logic of geography? First one, there are cities where there are rivers. Cities appear as they are not from 6 miles above the ground. It is easy to understand why valleys are populated. It is difficult to understand why humans hate and kill one another. The earth is round and it has more sea than land. You need to give the statements that are example of logic of geography. So the first logic of geography is the first one itself. There are cities where there are rivers. This is right. Then it is easy to understand why valleys are populated. Again, this is right. And then the earth is round and it has more sea than land. This is also right. So the first statement, the third statement, and the fourth statement is right. Now we come to the fourth question, where they have asked, mention two things that are clear from the height. Number two, not clear from the height. When we come to the first part, clear from the height it was clear that there are populated cities and valleys of the countries near rivers. It was also clear that the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. First thing. Now come to the second part. Not clear. From the height, it was not clear why men on the earth found reasons to hate each other. It was also not understandable why men had to build walls across cities. Why they had to kill. When nature has not made any boundaries, why man is trying to divide the beautiful world by walls. These were the things that were not clear. You can see in the last stanza only, it was not clear why they hate each other, build walls across cities, kill each other. This was not clear. Whereas the clear things were that the valleys were more populated, earth was round, it had more sea than land. Now, it's the time of rhyming scheme. When I talk about the rhyming scheme in this poem, the rhyming scheme of all the stanzas in this poem is A, B, C, D, B, C, D, A. I'll come again. A, B, C, D, B, C, D, A. Now, this is the rhyming scheme of all the stanzas in the poem. Figure of speech. When I talk about the figure of speech, there are two important figure of speech mentioned in the poem. The first one is imagery, where the walls symbolize the borders and cities symbolize the countries. I'll just go back. The walls symbolize the borders, whereas the cities symbolize the countries. And there is an example of alliteration given here, that is, it scaled 6 inches by the valleys were. You can just see here, it's scaled 6 inches by the valleys were. Scaled 6 inches, that is alliteration. And by the valleys were. Now, time for assignment. You will be doing the working with text as I have discussed with you all the answers in your notebook or wherever you are working with it. Answers for the same will be uploaded in your ERP. Thank you.